Hi guys, and a welcome from me. Another video on Championship Manager 0102, the epic game that is now over 20 years old and still thousands and thousands of people still love playing such a game. So today's video is going to be an update on my three-man network game that I've got going, the ongoing game that's been going on for over 8 years. For those of you that are on the CMO102.net website, you'll know about it. Same with the Facebook CMO102 group. You'll possibly have seen some updates on it. I've just restored this game as a solo game because I've moved on to a different device, in case you're wondering why you see changed player there. So, without further ado, let's tell you where we are. We have just not long concluded season 113. I'll try and do a recap as real quick and brief as possible, because on one of my other videos I waffle on about where we're at and what we've done and blah blah blah. So season 113, Tapani 2.19, October 2013 update. We started this game back in December 2013. Season 113, it was my first league title for Chelsea. It's my first league title for Chelsea since I moved from Swansea. You'll see Swansea's not lit up because I'm no longer Swansea, but that was me. Same with Spurs, and the same with Peterborough, and the same with Liverpool, and the same with Scunthorpe. They were all me, and Pep and Ian are at Southampton and Manchester United. So last season, this is a new season that we kicked in yesterday. Last season, you know, I feel I've got my strongest squad that I've had. I have worked out a few of who my players are regen-wise. A few of them are quite obvious. For example, that guy is clearly Messi. I assumed that was Suarez, but it's not. It turns out that is Suarez. I thought that was Aguero. It's not. It turns out that is Aguero. So from my personal perspective, I've got my strongest squad that I've ever had, and it's a blend of experience and, you know, people in their prime and some youngsters. That's Yaya Toure, who can't really break in, to be honest with you, because I don't know who this is, but he's a fucking machine. Look at him. That I'm quite certain is Aaron Ramsey, who I've just picked up recently, but he probably won't break in, to be honest with you. My defence is probably my weakest position, in my opinion. I thought this guy that I've recently picked up was Vidic, but surprise, surprise, I've already got Vidic. So we won the title last season, Chelsea. But as you will see, we lost the Champions League. And look at that. I know we could have won that. We should have won that. And FYI, that is Neymar. That is a Neymar regen. So Man United, Ian's Man United, you know, deservedly, I suppose you could say. But they beat us fair and square. That's probably the right word. And they win the Champions League. You'll see I knocked Pepe out along the way. The FA Cup. Now, I beat Sunderland AI in the final. That is a new record in the FA Cup. The record is it's 4 in a row from any one of us. 4 in a row. The record in the League Cup is 6 in a row. And that was from Pep. Ian is within touch and distance of that, because Ian, he won that against AI with Man United last season. And if we can just get to it, he beat Birmingham City in the final. And that is now 5 in a row for Ian. The record, as I said, is 6 in a row from Pepe. There you go, back in 2047 to 2052, 6 in a row. The Premiership, now this was what was important about the Premiership, because I hold the record of 5 in a row with Spurs, which you can see right there in 2108 through to 12. And Ian now, as you can see, before last season, 8 titles in the last 9 years. Pepe prevented him taking 5 in a row, and I prevented him doing 5 in a row last season. So, I have the record on that. Ian, meanwhile, has the record on the Champions League. Pepe, he'd already set that up with 4 in a row. That the record was 3, but he was just looking to expand it last season. No, sorry, I got that wrong. The season before last. But Pepe halted that. So 4 in a row, and Ian won it last season, as you just saw. So last season was an absolute woeful season for Pep. He won jack shit. He won absolutely nothing or nothing of interest. And you can see he finished with 90 points. He's finished third. You can see Pep's finished third in the Premiership for the last five seasons. And it's really been the chance for me to really excel for Chelsea. So from my own point of view, I've got this Welsh centre-half. I don't know who he is. I was grooming him. Not sure if that's the right word I should use, but anyway, I'm grooming him from the youngsters. And last season, he had a really good loan spell. Now, it's clear to be seen. Anyone who knows this game knows that the loan element in it is flawed. They don't have the same effect as what they probably should have. But you've got to remember, this is a 20-year-old game. However, this particular guy, Brian Morris, had a great loan spell. And as a result of that loan spell at Leighton Orient, it is developing, there's no doubt about that. But I do still think that defence is my weakest position. Carl Harper, I don't know who he is. I don't think it's John Terry. Could be Ferdinand, Rio Ferdinand, I'm not 100% sure. This guy here, who's the modern day Robertson at Liverpool. He was an assist machine for me last season. 13 he got at left back as we claim the title. Right back, didn't really get a chance last season, my right back, McGowan, because... Oh, I had an Italian right back who I've since flogged. No, and then I brought this guy as well, who has started well, and in the games he played last season, I think I picked him up in January, he's come in really, really well. So let's just have a quick gander at my midfield. Pedroso, looking really good, still only 21, and I picked him up for what I feel was a bargain. But this guy here, Robin Huiskamp, auto value is 90. It was 23. I'm sure it was 23 million that was. Or it might have been that guy. No. That's what I'm talking about, players in their prime. You know, I've fucked up a lot about trying to play players that I've just bought and not giving them enough time to blend in. And credit where it's due, Andrew Vince is very good at that. And I'm very guilty of it, of not, I throw players in and expect it. But credit where it's due to Andrew, he's done a really good job over the years when he's played it, and I'm trying to learn from that. So, with Neymar, now, we've all seen, haven't we, where you've got a forward and he appears as your midfielders, which obviously means he can probably play in an advanced midfield slot. So, my current lineup at the minute, or what has been so far this season, is that. Now, initially, I had Benitez up top. I think he was unfit for a game, so I gave this guy Andres Abreu a game. I think that was probably the last game, and he didn't exactly let me down, did he? Two goals in an hour, and a 10 rating. So I picked up this guy. He ain't gonna make it. He's got the creativity. And the dribbling and the finishing and the off the ball and the pace and the passing. You know, ordinarily, he'd probably walk straight into a team. But there's so much competition, you know. And that's what I mean about Neymar, the Neymar de Oliveira. He ain't going to break in, but I could technically play him in the midfield side of things. But then do I want to play him in the midfield? Medina, absolute fucking monster for me. And he was last season as well. As you can see, 22 goals. And that is in that position where I've got him. And on the right of midfield, this Huissam, you know, he's done really, really well for me. So, DMC, meanwhile, Gullier, who's been my player of the season for the last 2 years, been absolutely brilliant. However, it didn't stop me from bringing in this German who I pipped Pep to. So, that's where we're at with me. And obviously, my goalkeepers, my Mexican goalkeeper is still my undisputed number one goalkeeper now. Durant is my number two. And although he's a beast, and my number three, I fucked off, and I think, I hope, it's Buffon. So, that's me. Let's have a look now then at Ian. He's not made any signings since the turn of June update, but he did make a couple when the window opened. He brought this guy off me. Now, it's a strange one, really, because I got him, I had him a while back, and I trained him to be centre. Then I decided to fuck him off and sold him to Pep, as you can see right there. And then I brought him back because I was using wingers, and it just wasn't working. So I just fucked him off again. And whilst when he went to Pep, he lost his central positioning because Pep was using him on the wing. So I'm surprised that Ian's bought him, because ordinarily Ian, well, not ordinarily, Ian always plays that setup. So, I don't know, it's an interesting one. Ian also brought this left back, very, very good. It's the sort of player that I would like to use. I wouldn't have him in my reserves personally, because 25, I have my own little ruling of nobody over the age of 21. In terms of Ian, Ian's still got the goal machine, Alex Gill. I mean, look at him, he's a fucking insane. And all you've got to do is look at his last seasons for that. It's absolutely insane. And the funny thing is I sold him to him from Swansea when I was Swansea manager. So, you know, it's a great... And obviously the fact that he's done so well, he's a Zlatan regen, who is a fucking beast, hasn't really had the sort of games he wants. So, from that perspective. A strange buy from Ian. Now, this was really bizarre, because this guy here, Richard McKay, Ian had him ages ago, and he was a good player to me. I think, yeah, he was one. He bought him from Swansea after I left Swansea. So, you know, like AI do, they flog their players, and Ian picked him up. Ian then sold him. And then, as you can see, 2 years ago, Ian picks him up, and it made no sense. There's only one part of sense that makes, and I could be wrong on this, but why would Ian pick up a forward who's clearly not going to break into his team? As you can see, he did not break into his team bar one league game, and he stuck him in the reserves. And the only solution I can think is Ian wants to keep track of when he retires, so at least he'll be notified when he retires, which is fair enough, and I get that. The reason I wouldn't do that personally, I would have him just on my short list and just keep checking. It takes up a place in your squad. But if Ian's got the space, then it's fair enough, you know, because he's obviously got him on a long-term contract. So we'll see where we're at with Ian there. Ian did buy this player off me. Did very well last season for him, to be fair, but he was causing a lot of issues with me, and he did my nut in, to be honest with you. Ian also brought in this guy, Alessandro Gomez. Now, he's been around the block with all of us. I had him, I exchanged him to Pep. Pep didn't do very well at Pep. I took him back for a little bit, did shit, then I fucked him off, and now Ian's bought him. So, and he's got him loan listed, so I don't know. He looks really good, to be fair. He's got some really good attributes. He's not got the pace, obviously, but tackling, positioning, passing, jumping, marking, decisions, even the crossing on the left back. And dribbling is 14 along with. So I don't know. If Ian can get something out of him, then good luck to him. Let's have a quick gander at Pep then. Pep has sold what I believe was Romelu Lukaku regen. And he has still got, of course, Ronaldo. He's still got, obviously, Ryan Giggs as well. Pepe needs to do something. A surprise move from Pep saw him buy Tony Sykes. I don't know. I'm not really convinced, if I'm truly honest. And more so because, basically, I bought Sykes from Boston, as you can see, in 23-24, as I was just sort of building my Chelsea. Pep then took him on an exchange. Pep then offered him back to me, because I think he was causing problems, but fucked him off to Parma, and now he's re-bought him, and I'm not really, really sure, if I'm truly honest, what the deal is. There is a player I would like from Pep. I have spoke to him, but he's not willing to entertain it. It was one of my former players at Chelsea that I do have a big regret of selling. That is Varane. As you can see, he's had a shit start. I mean, we've all had perfect starts at the minute. Pep had to play Champions League qualifying. Now, we have, obviously, I don't know if you've maybe seen it in glance, the Charity Shield. Man United 2, Chelsea 5. Very, very pleased with that, if I'm truly honest with you, given the stats as well. Ian has started well. He's won the Intercontinental. He's won the Super Cup. The reason the Intercontinental takes place, remember that this is over 8 years old, and we were using an old patch, which was, of course, at the time, the up-to-date patch. Same with the updating players as well. We started this in December 2013, so subsequently the most up-to-date update that was available was the autumn 2013. So that's where we're at with the game. So Ian's also, just quickly, Eden Hazard. I'm obviously keeping a mental note of Eden Hazard because Ian, I think, will... I mean, he has got him under contract for another 3 more years, but... I make notes of players just to remind myself. Then I just forget certain things. He's a good centre-half, defensive midfielder. Another player that he took off me. You've got to think to yourself, why would I... You're probably asking yourself, why do I sell players to my rivals? I took Chelsea, I left Swansea, and I took Chelsea in the third division. Of course, it's not Championship, League One, it's Prem 1, 2, 3. I, as I said before in my previous videos, for me, this ongoing three-man game, to keep it interesting almost, it's a case of taking on a new challenge. Now, surprisingly to me, Pep moved to Southampton after 4 years, and Ian moved off to Man United after about 6 years. And here we are, season 113. Now, you can't tell me, don't do an element, get boring. We all started out as little teams, and I started with Scunthorpe, and I was with Scunthorpe for 54 years. And when I moved, I know it shocked those guys, but it was a case of time for something new. So, you know, from my own point of view, from my own perspective, let's have a look at jobs. You know, I've been around the block with the international side of things, but yeah, Spurs, you see, Swansea in 13. I weren't at Swansea for very long, to be fair. Swansea, 5 years. 5 years with Swansea, and my objective was always to win the league at least once, win the League Cup, win the FA Cup, and the Champions League, and I achieved my objective. The same with all my teams. So Spurs, as you see, Peterborough. The reason Peterborough, it's mine and Pep's hometown. And as you can see, I was at Peterborough for 12 years, 11 and a half years. Yeah, 11 and a half years at Peterborough and 10 and a half years at Spurs. Liverpool, I was there for, 21 years, Liverpool, something like that. And Scunthorpe, I was there for 54 successful years. In terms of money, money's not an issue to me whatsoever. It never really has been since I joined Chelsea, over the £1 billion mark. In respect of my tactics, now I'm not going to indulge too much into my tactics, other than it's my boom tactic, which I have modified a little bit, and I modify them from game to game. Some people do that a lot. Some people micromanage, tactician. I am doing something. I've got something in my head which I don't want to indulge into just yet, but I have changed this boom tactic a little bit. Now you see that Neto in the middle there, he's got an arrow going forward, so you could argue that they're all running into each other. If you see, you've got Messi, my little career Messi, he'll be running into the striker, but it won me the title last season, this did. And the big thing for me, one little thing I will let you into, this is part of my ongoing development of the tactic, you'll see that Neto, who's doing really, really well, he came from my reserves. I bought him a couple of seasons ago, and you can see he spent a lot of that in the reserves. Last season I brought him up, and now if you can see that he's got goals 10, assists 11, and the big thing for me that I'm trying, if I show you, is I'm playing a real long shot game. 14 long shots is acceptable, but the long shots, that's a big thing for me at the minute, is my long shots. So that is that. So yep, that's where we're at then. So we're off and running, season 114. Let's have a quick gander now then at the international side of things. Pepe is still Germany. Ian is still Spain. I left Egypt at the end of last season after the World Cup. I took over Egypt just for the World Cup because, as a lot of you may know, particularly back on this update, a lot of the international side of things is flawed, particularly with the African teams. I took Egypt after they sacked their manager after confirming their place in the World Cup. There you go. And I won the African Nations, and I got knocked out in the group stages of last year's World Cup. I then resigned shortly after before they sacked me. Pepe is Germany, Ian is Spain. Now, the World Cup last season, Pepe beat Spain in the final, and they also beat them in the Confederations Cup final this season. So Pepe got bragging rights. I think Pep has probably been the most successful of us on the international side of things. I'd have to check that though to confirm. It's definitely not me. That is definite. But credit where it's due to Pep here. He's on his off his third or fourth stint as manager of Germany. Ian, and as you can see there, the World Cup final, Pepe won that as well, probably against the run of play. So credit where it's due. If I was to analyse that, I was thinking of this yesterday. If I was to analyse the international events, you know, the Euros, I mean, what do you classify as an important event? I mean, when it gets to the domestic side of things, to me, the important things to win primarily is the league, the Champions League, the FA Cup, the League Cup. I'm not really give two shits about things like the Charity Shield, the World Club Cup, the Intercontinental, the Super. In the world side of things, definitely the World Cup and probably the Euros. If you're Brazil, maybe the Copa America. If you're an African team, you know, I don't know. So we'd have to discuss that if I was to try and do some sort of analysing of that. But this is the thing, you see, the African teams, you'll get sacked. I mean, do you remember what I said in the last video? I don't know. You may have even seen this actually, and just to prove that it's complete bollocks. The very first international job I got, no, the second one, sorry. Back on the 15th of June 2025, I took over Ivory Coast. I had a game, I won it. And as you can see there, I got dismissed a month later. So, bullshit. And obviously, the biggest flaw of this is a lot of the international jobs now, they don't come vacant. Even if their manager does resign, it's like random fucking scouts and players take the job. It's all fucked up, and there's only a selection of countries that you can now take. So guys, hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, pop them down in the box. If you've got any requests for anything CM related, do let me know, and I will try to make a video regarding it, because I know it's been a while since I've done some videos, but it's been a while since I've had a day's holiday like today. So until next time guys, take it easy.